baby brother or sister, a pony, or a leather jacket.
Okay, she really wanted that leather jacket.
She didn't get any other one.
So today is what's called an issues lesson. It's not one of the Ten Commandments, here are the rules to the church. It's an issue that we're all going to face, unfortunately, in our life, and that is suffering through sickness, whether it's ourselves or our family member. So it's an issue, and I'm going to share with you a story about my life and how I have had to deal with this issue, and hopefully it will give you guys some strength and a guidepost when you inevitably will have to go through something like this too. So it's not going to be really a happy talk. It will end happy. We always say God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Is that true? When you're sick, is that true? When you're hurting, is that true? Spoiler alert, it's always true. Is it always easy to believe that? 20 years ago, the rug got ripped out from underneath in a way that shook my world to its core. I was so happy, I was engaged, I had a great job. And then the phone rang. Three words I will never forget. Dad has cancer. Here I am preparing for one of the happiest days of my life. Dad is fighting for his. God's good? All the time? How is that good? How is cancer good for anyone? He was lucky he had the old man's cancer. Prostate cancer grows slowly, and he was only 50. Not an old man, it's a disease 70-year-old men get. Something like 75 to 80% of men die with it, or some sort of prostate disease, not from it. Okay, God is good. He's young and healthy. Got it early. All right, we can get through it. God is good all the time. And here he was good because Dad got it early, caught it early, totally treatable. So he had radiation, had all sorts of meds 2 weeks before my wedding. All of his scans and tests came back clean. Woo! God is good. Let's party. Let's have a wedding. Awesome. 18 months later, I'm pregnant with Miranda, sitting in a surgical waiting room because Dad had cancer again. His second primary cancer. And for those of you who don't know that much about cancer, primary means it starts all on its own. It hadn't spread. Prostate was the first primary spot. His bladder was the second. That happened because the treatment for his prostate, the radiation, found part of his bladder. Those cells freaked out, mutated, and caused cancer. Okay, so this is good because we just kept out. It was a side effect. We had him in at breakfast, home by lunch. All was good. God is good all the time. Miranda was born, hooray! 3 years later, Chase was born, hooray! 3 years later, Dad's shaving. There's a lump in his neck. See where this is going? Dad had cancer again. His third primary cancer. Hadn't spread from the prostate, hadn't spread from the bladder. This was its own creature. So this is when God is good. It was really hard for me to believe. I yelled at God. I had some choice words for God that were not very Christian. I was mad and scared. I didn't understand why my hero was still hurting. Oh, Adam and Eve and that fruit. It's because of them, right? It's because we're supposed to share and curse. We have to share it three times? You have to share cancer? Seriously? oldest of four boys, put himself through college, enlisted in the Navy during Vietnam, been married to my mom for 50 years, raised three kids, put us all through college. What did he do? Why does he have cancer three times? Could it be him? Was it because of me? Something I did. I was being punished. I go to church. I cry for mass, trying to figure out why. God is good. He doesn't want us hurting. He wants us happy and with him in heaven. I wanted my dad with me on earth and well. I didn't get it. So they didn't get all the thyroid cancer out. Apparently it's like trying to take bubble gum off of hair without breaking the hair. So they said, oh, every couple of years it's going to have to come and get little cells taken out as they grow. Great. They paralyzed his vocal cord, which makes surgeries that much more difficult for him. Great. This is my good God. So, 8 years ago on my birthday, worst birthday ever. Never been a specialist in Hershey because dad's cancer spread. Cancer is not bad enough, now it's spread to his lungs. Yay! Doctor gave him 3 to 5 years to live. Happy birthday, Alyssa. God is good. There was a magic pill that he could take twice a day that would help him get to the 5-year end of that prognosis. It was not FDA approved. $1,000 a pill, 2 times a day, 5 years, do the math. $3.6 million to keep my dad alive for 5 years. He asked for a second opinion. So we go out to Sloan Kettering, and as we're pulling into the parking lot, Hershey doctor called and said, oh, your insurance covered it. Oh, God is good. Okay. We don't all have to refinance our houses, downsize, get extra jobs. We'll at least get to that 5 years, right? Well, the Sloan Kettering doctor said, the doctor who made that medicine is at the University of Pennsylvania Hospital in Philly. How about I get you an appointment there? So she goes, I don't want you taking that medicine that I discovered with the Hershey medicine. I want you to take this even better one. I want you to have my clinical trial. So my dad agrees. Asks him for some more surgeries, which scared me to death. He's cut from here to here. He had scars that you would not believe all over his body. And I'm looking at him and he's smiling. He's making nurses laugh and feel better. Lifting everybody else's spirits. Why, I'm about ready to vomit and I'm crying. Like, Dad, aren't you mad at God? He's like, I'm really mad at God for putting me through this. And he's like, no, I'm not. Like, seriously? He's like, Alyssa, it could be worse. I looked at my dad there in the hospital bed, how on earth could this get worse? How could it be worse? And he said, better me than you. Your kids, your mom, your brother, your sister. I'll take this. I'll fight this. That's a dad for you, right? And he said, if God gave me a chance to fight, it's cancer. I can fight this. There's medicine. There's things I can do. Billy Bryant didn't have a choice. He couldn't fight. God took him in his hand. And then he said, what they learned from me in this trial is going to help somebody else's dad, grandpa, mother, sister. Because if my suffering is going to help somebody, so I completely lost it. Here he is. Suffering, healing from surgeries, taking medicines that are doing crazy things to his body. he's doing okay. A year ago on Christmas, he really, or on Easter, he really shared in Christ's suffering because he had his fourth cancer. He's cut from here to here because it's in his liver. And I'm going to lose it. So I don't really want to go to Mass. But I will tell you, over the past 20 years, I never did quit God. I questioned God. I cried. I yelled at God. But I never quit God. I was just trying to figure out what he was trying to teach us here. Didn't always get it. So I didn't want to go to Mass one day. Holy Spirit works in mysterious ways, and I wound up going. I was a little late, so I didn't get my best seat. So I was a little off. Wasn't entirely focused. Until, because when Monsignor was still here, Monsignor gets up and says, "Hey," something to his words, "ever wonder why God, who loves us, lets us get sick?" Yes? The Holy Spirit needed me at that Mass for this message. At that instant, it was just Monsignor and me in the church. Everybody else blacked out. It was like he was talking straight to me. This is a message I needed to hear. Why does God let us get sick? Little Alice's lemonade stand, a little kid gets cancer. What did a little kid do? It wasn't what she did. Through Alex's suffering, pediatric cancer research runs through the roof. Right? Superman broke the back, just Reeves. So now there's all sorts of fundraising for spinal cord injuries. Through his suffering, that good came. I can't remember the name of the guy who started that ice bucket challenge for ALS, but look at how much money he raised. So through our suffering, Monsignor said, the Holy Spirit shines through us, brings us closer to God, closer to each other. That is God's ultimate goal, for us to get closer to Him. So my dad sitting there, could be worse, better me than you. I'm going to help somebody. It's like, that's it. The Holy Spirit is speaking through him through his suffering. He is showing me how to live better. He's showing me how not to give up on God. I still don't get it all the time. My dad helps me see it. And I don't know how you guys spent your New Year's Eve, but I was driving to the ER. And as I was driving, I said, "Why, God?" And I thought of this lesson. And I said, a lesson from the Holy Spirit in this. And I tell you, I kind of haven't yet for this round of ER visits. The past month, he spent 15 days in the hospital. So I'm still working on it. But I know it's there. The spark of the Holy Spirit, sometimes it's just a little ember you have to look for. Sometimes, like in a baby's birth, it's glorious and bright and amazing. But why we suffer, it's hard to understand. It's okay to cry and wonder and worry and feel bad. As long as you know that God's not leaving you alone, he's not doing it because he's mad at you or punishing you for anything. He's doing it because through you there's a message of his that's getting out there. Keep fighting. Help others. You have a chance. Keep it up. So when the going gets tough, just think of that. And it will get tough for all of us at some point. And prayers are always welcome. So now we're going to